Hey y'all, for those of you new here, my name is RK Gold. I'm an author and business consultant living down in New Orleans, Louisiana. And today I'm going to be reacting to Imaginary Places by Busdriver. This was requested by Read and Rap, so thank you for the recommendation. As always, if you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button with the bell notification. You can follow me on social media at AuthorRKGold. That's at AuthorRKGold on Twitter and Instagram. You can leave me your recommendations either in the comments below or in my DMs, they're always open. Thanks for watching. Let's just keep enjoying great music together. All right, let's dive in. We have Imaginary Places by Busdriver. Ooh, that beat. Let's do it. Okay, the levels for the beat to lyrics feel a little off. I feel like the instrumentals are a little too high or the vocals are a little too low, or both. But let's double check. One thing I like is he has his lyrics in the comment section. Okay, his flow is giving me some ODB vibes. Not quite to the full extent of ODB singing, but there is some there's a bit of an eccentricity there that gives me some older D bastard vibes. As far as what he's saying right now, I'm just here to hold your hand when you die and to show you around imaginary places. Put money lumps in my bloody stumps. That's pretty vivid imagery going on right there. Put money lumps. That gives you a bit of texture in my bloody stumps. Like that's some fluid right there. I mean, you can feel that. That this is music you can feel. And I don't mean like emotionally. I mean like I'm just like can taste it. I get that metallic taste in my mouth from the blood. You know, I'm moving my hands right now. Like he's a very tactile rapper right now. So as far as I talk about sensory, I talk about senses and sensory, I guess, rapping, targeting with visuals, with imagery. Obviously, rap itself is it captures hearing, but this is capturing that third sense, that feel, that touch. As far as what he's saying right now, though, I just want to hold your hand when you die, again, going back to touch, and show you around imaginary places. Put money lumps in my bloody stumps. Rhyme, mid-rhyme, end-rhyme. And I will have a smile that's a perfect circle. Die in your sleep, but the sky at your feet. Mid-rhyme, end-rhyme. So we're seeing a bit of a pattern right here. I'll shoot you when you're happy on the day that you will find peace. We're getting some contrasting images now. So we have money, obviously, wealth. Now you could make the argument that blood and money do go together. I mean, for example, there is blood money. That's a thing. But you could also make the argument that one is pain and one's prosperity. And then going down to shoot you when you're happy on the day that you'll find peace. That's obviously contrasting visuals. You have death and violence on the day that you find peace on a day that you're happy. So one thing that he's doing so well is not just having this eccentric flow, which I mentioned before, reminding me of ODB. He's really creating some tension through polar opposite visuals, through just completely contrasting ideas, and it's really popping off of the lyrics, really popping off of the beat. Like that was so ODB right there. Okay, that got into some faith right there. We have no needle skipping in my ecosystem. That's giving us some secular existence. I guess we can just say ecosystem, just us being able to be alive, interact with our environments. But in the audience may be an evil Christian. Then we get, but they charge me for a halo. I mean, that's a pretty profound line right there. The fact that in Christianity, for example, with tithings, you essentially pay your penance. Charging you for a halo that does go back to, like, for example, Martin Luther nailing up his theses on the wall, and calling out the evil in Catholicism that he saw back then, and the corruption of money and God. So just a very profound bar right there. And then he continues on it. I play dead songs on a silk screen, just going back to so much of the song is talking about peace, violence, and death. And then it is known to lead the way to the stairwell. It's very difficult for me not to think of Stairway to Heaven right now when I hear stairwell on a song like this, especially when it's followed up by to God's administrative office and the final farewell. These are some tough words to rap at this speed as well, so that's all the more impressive right now. I'm also a fan of just his voice. He has a very unique sound. He has a very unique voice. I'm not a fan of the levels. I really would love it if the instrumentals were down a little bit, so it could have highlighted his voice a little more. But you can really, there's so much to like about how he's pronouncing these words. There's so much to like about his little, you know, like the way he's talking from the back of his mouth, not quite the back of his throat, but like the back of his mouth and his cheeks. It's giving him a really unique sound. This flow is very fast. And it's crazy because he's not a mumble rapper by any stretch of the imagination right now. Some things are difficult to pick up, partially due to the levels, partially just due to the fact that these are difficult words, some complicated rhymes, spoken very fast. This is just crazy. I mean, as far as what he's talking about, right now what I'm sensing as far as a pattern is concerned, each verse sort of starts low and goes high and then falls off a cliff and we sort of just start over again. So these verses are hitting us like waves. But I'm just here to hold your hand when you die. That's a recurring line that we see a lot right now. Getting a little creepy at this point. To give your assault rifle a banana clip, deadly again. He mentioned earlier in the song that he would shoot you on your happy day, so you can find peace. Glow in the dark when I stroll in the park. Mid rhyme, end rhyme. So these are following a pretty, it might sound like chaos, but when I'm reading the lyrics out loud and when I'm actually seeing them on the screen, they actually follow a pretty consistent pattern. He does a lot of single syllable and mid rhyme, end rhymes early on in the verses. In fact, let's go back for a second. We have let's see for a second. No, not there. I definitely saw one in one of the earlier lines right now of sleep and feet right there. That's a single syllable mid rhyme and a single syllable end rhyme on the fifth line, I believe, sixth. And then this one was the third one. So they're not perfectly parallel, but they are close. And then we actually have the same sound. We have C and seat in that third verse, and that would be the fifth and sixth. So he actually does match the rhymes quite well. I wonder if he does that in the next verse. No, he doesn't. But what's the five? Was and cut. No. Okay. So I was definitely trying to find a pattern that wasn't fully there. But as far as the actual mid rhyme and end rhyme thing, that does exist. That is a pattern. It's just not the same rhyme sounds. So we are seeing some consistency in this chaos. I gotta rewind. Yeah. We're definitely seeing some patterns emerging. Yeah. so violent. It's so violent in such a happy tone. Okay.
If you want to piss off your parents, show interest in the arts. Kids, if you really want to piss off your parents, buy real estate in an imaginary place.
Oh, this is about to drop hard. Yes. Ooh, that scratch.
Gotta do my shout outs now.
These two.
I'm just gonna hold your hand.
Go off, Mr. Busdriver. Yo, I really fuck with that. Thanks a lot for the recommendation, man. Let me double check who recommended. Read and rap. Thanks a lot for that recommendation, man. That was killer. That was exactly what I was looking for. Very unique style. Very eccentric style. I'm a big fan of his flow. I'm a big fan of his voice. Even amongst the chaos, you could find patterns. Has a lot of texture in those rhymes. A lot of, as I mentioned before, a lot of tactile, a lot of touch. Just a lot to build on. I definitely want to give him another chance. I want to listen to more of his work. Thank you so much for the recommendation. As always, if you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button with the bell notification. You can follow me on social media at AuthorRKGold. That's at AuthorRKGold on Twitter and Instagram. My DMs are always open, so you can leave your recommendations in the comments or in my DMs. Thanks again. Let's just keep enjoying great music together.